Let me ask you something. Does this look like the type of face that would get involved in some drug-induced turf war? No, it doesn't. Now, a drug-induced orgy? Okay, maybe. But this is 2020, bitch, and you gotta nuck if you buck out here. About a year ago, I started going to a fat doctor. And every time I tell people that, they look shocked. They're like, oh, but you're not even that fat. It's like, yeah, Janice, that means it's working. I mean, it's like, good. That's the plan. Like, wouldn't that statement be more preposterous if I was built like a fucking refrigerator? I mean, that would be shocking, you know? You'd be like, okay, so have you actually been going, or do you just pass the place on your way to Wendy's? Truth be told, I haven't lost a pound since I've been going, but I haven't gained a pound either. So really, I wasn't even that fat when I started going. Now, you could say I was just planning ahead, but really, I'm just in it for the drugs. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, they prescribe you this appetite suppressant called Atapex, which is basically just diet meth, or cocaine for fatties. I love it, okay? But you gotta be overweight to get it, which is why I ride that fine line between dad bod and diabetic coma. It makes for awkward conversation in the waiting room, though, because most of the people that go there are morbid obese. So they see me as like this beacon of hope. If I just keep coming in here, that's gonna be me someday. They don't even realize that I'm the before and after picture. I'm no success story. I'm a false god with an addiction to great value speed. What's really crazy is that the fat doctor is actually a fat doctor. Like, when she walked into the room for my first consultation, I thought she was a patient looking for the bathroom. Then she sat down and started telling me weight loss tips. I was like, well, this is awkward. I mean, I'm not into fat shaming, but I also wouldn't go see Tiger Woods for marriage counseling either, you know? I mean, how fucked up would it be if you went to the dentist and he walked in with no teeth and was like, have you been flossing good? It's like, bitch, how did you even get this job? But I didn't realize how cutthroat things could get in some of these clinics, though. I was in the waiting room and this lady walked in with this giant bag of Skittles and just gave it to the receptionist. Then not even 15 minutes later, another lady walked in with a 10-pound sack of potatoes and 2 cans of Cheese Whiz and just gave them to the receptionist. I finally had to ask what the hell was going on. I was like, is this some sort of sacrificial food drive? Do they think this food's going to Buddha and in return he's going to make them all skinny? This bitch looked at me like my idea was far-fetched and then began to explain to me that those women worked next door at the eye clinic. I was like, oh, they being petty. Like, shit, my bad. I didn't realize I was witnessing gang violence between the high-pressured bloods and the can't-see Crips. But nobody was doing shit about it. And I was like, you know what? Fuck it. I'm part of the Chubb squad. If I have to be the one to settle the score, so be it. I got up, walked straight next door into that waiting room, and I just plop, 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 Captain Insano'd every blind soul in that motherfucker. I poked them all in the eye. Every single one of them. Women and children. I felt like a hero. A vigilante for those with high cholesterol. But they weren't happy with me at all. Turns out they were just sharing their break room while the eye clinics was being renovated. So, now I need a new plug.